Based on the slow drag, a couple's dance common to the juke and the honky-tonk. The piece is controversial for audiences in 1940.
Barrel House Blues was depicting the time in Chicago when it was cold, and just knowing this lonely woman who felt a little beat up went on in a bar and had the time of her life, just for a moment, finds this young man and fantasizes.
The critics were just baffled. They were ignorant to the fact that this was a combination of the authentic with the artistic. So they reverted back to their safety of, it was sizzling, it was hot, it was torrid, it was sexy and all that business.
Though the reviews are enthusiastic, they're laced with a tone of condescension. John Martin, America's leading dance critic, calls Barrel House Blues an incredible vulgarity in the New York Times.
Like any innovator, you're bound to give your audience trouble, and Catherine Dunham did. What they saw, many a critic dismissed as cabaret. And they felt it had no depth. That wasn't true.
It was sassy, and she was courageous. She would always take risks, always with her material. Even though they may criticize her, like maybe that was too risque, she wanted them to know we're complex people.
Here's someone who said this is important, vernacular dance. The idea of looking at the blues experience in the body, the idea of looking at the jazz experience in the body, the idea of looking at the spiritual experience in the body through dance, that's a powerful legacy.